Do you ever feel like your days get hijacked by distractions, leaving your biggest goals on the back burner? Welcome, and welcome back to Empower and Thrive. I'm Christina, a corporate VP in the finance industry with over 20 years' experience. Today, we're diving into one of the most powerful habits from Stephen Covey's 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, Habit 3, Put First Things First. This habit is all about prioritizing the most important things in your life, not just the urgent ones. It's a game changer when it comes to your personal finances and career growth, and we'll explore exactly how you can start applying it today to see real progress in your life. Let's jump in. What does it really mean to put first things first? It means getting crystal clear on your priorities and focusing your time and energy on the activities that bring you closer to your goals, whether that's financial independence, career advancement, or personal fulfillment. Putting first things first is about stepping back from the busyness of everyday tasks and asking yourself, is this the best use of my time? When you're working toward financial success, putting first things first means being mindful about how you manage your spending and saving. It's easy to get caught up in the moment, whether it's an impulse purchase or feeling pressured to spend to keep up with trends. But often, these things distract us from what's truly important, like building an emergency fund or investing for the future. When you start focusing on what really matters, your financial decisions become more intentional. You're not just getting by day-to-day anymore. You're creating real financial security and setting yourself up for long-term freedom. In your career, putting first things first can completely change the way you work. It's easy to feel overwhelmed by emails, meetings, and small tasks that seem urgent but don't really move you toward your long-term goals. This habit helps you break free from that constant rush. Instead of letting the urgent dictate your calendar, you can start focusing on tasks that truly contribute to your growth, development, and success. Picture blocking off the first hour of your workday to dedicate to something meaningful, like planning your next big career move or learning a new skill. This shift in focus not only boosts your productivity, but also helps you stand out. You'll be the one who consistently gets the important work done, making a real difference in your progress. Now, let's talk about how to actually put this habit into practice. Stephen Covey introduced the Time Management Matrix, a powerful tool to help you categorize your tasks based on urgency and importance. The matrix divides tasks into 4 distinct quadrants. Quadrant 1, urgent and important. These are the tasks that require your immediate attention because they involve pressing deadlines or crises. For example, dealing with emergencies, last-minute assignments, or addressing a health issue. While these tasks are necessary, spending too much time here can lead to constant firefighting and burnout. Quadrant 2, not urgent, but important. This is where you want to focus most of your time. Quadrant 2 tasks are the proactive activities that contribute to long-term success, such as strategic planning, personal development, building relationships, and improving skills. These tasks don't demand immediate attention, but they are crucial for growth, both personally and professionally. Think budgeting, learning new skills, fostering connections, and planning for the future. Although they aren't the loudest demands in your life, they will provide the biggest returns if prioritized. Quadrant 3, urgent but not important. These are distractions that feel urgent but don't significantly contribute to your goals. Examples include unnecessary meetings, most phone calls, and other interruptions that feel pressing at the moment but are not aligned with your priorities. It's easy to get caught up here, reacting to others' demands, which can lead to inefficiency. Quadrant 4, not urgent and not important. This quadrant is where time is wasted. These are trivial activities like excessive social media browsing, watching TV, or engaging in other forms of escapism that provide little value. Spending too much time here keeps you from meaningful progress. The key is to minimize time in quadrants 3 and 4 and shift your focus towards quadrant 2, where the real growth happens. It's about making proactive, intentional choices rather than simply reacting to whatever comes up. By prioritizing quadrant 2 activities, you can build a foundation for long-term success and avoid the stress and chaos of constant urgency. When it comes to your finances, quadrant 2 activities might include reviewing your financial goals, researching investment options, or mapping out a debt repayment strategy. These aren't the things that scream for your attention right away, but they're crucial for your long-term financial health. And the best part? When you make time for these tasks regularly, you start to experience real momentum. You stop living paycheck to paycheck and start building wealth. In your career, quadrant 2 could mean networking with key people, seeking out mentorship, or working on a project that will enhance your future opportunities. It's about positioning yourself for growth, even when there's no immediate reward. By consistently working on these non-urgent, important tasks, you'll find that your career takes on a new trajectory. Instead of reacting to every little fire at work, you'll be shaping your future with intention and foresight. Here's a tip. Try starting your week by identifying your top 3 priorities, those tasks that, if completed, will have the biggest impact on your life. Then schedule them. Actually block out time on your calendar to focus on these high-value activities. This simple act of scheduling can drastically increase your chances of getting them done. Remember, what gets scheduled has a higher likelihood of getting done. A key mindset shift that comes with habit 3 is realizing that you are in control of your time. It's easy to feel like we're at the mercy of demands from others, our boss, our family, or social obligations. But by putting first things first, you reclaim your power. You decide what matters most and shape your day around it. This doesn't mean neglecting your responsibilities. It means learning to say no to the things that don't align with your priorities. And this goes hand in hand with financial success. By saying no to unnecessary expenses, like buying things you don't need just because they're on sale or keeping up with other spending habits, you free up your resources for the things that really matter: investing in your future, growing your savings, or maybe even starting a side business that can increase your income. Ultimately, Habit 3 is about aligning your daily actions with your biggest goals. It's about being intentional, proactive, and disciplined with both your time and your money. When you put first things first, you're not just managing your day, you're managing your life, your career, and your financial future. And that's what will take you from where you are now to where you truly want to be. Ask yourself this question: what are the important things in your life that you've been putting off? Maybe it's organizing your finances, making that career change you've been thinking about, or even just taking care of your physical and mental health. Whatever it is, now's the time to prioritize it. Start putting first things first and watch how everything else starts to fall into place. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, check out my videos on habits 1 and 2. I will link them here. And as always, keep thriving.